Hey guys, Ogs from the US. Welcome to the channel and thank you for watching. In this video, we are going to say officially welcome to Xavier Buyamba. He signed for Chelsea Football Club yesterday. We're gonna also talk about Izzy Brown. Do you think Izzy got a future at Chelsea Football Club? We're gonna also talk about everything that we have time for. But before anything, please help your brother out. Subscribe to the channel, like the video, comment down below, share, follow me on social media, and let's keep the conversation going. Xavier Buyamba, like I said in the beginning of this video, he joined Chelsea Football Club officially yesterday. He signed a 4 years contract with the Blue Side of London. What a news! He signed on free from Barcelona. I made a video explaining everything that happened with Xavier. He was last season training with the academy, and because of the transfer ban, he couldn't join Chelsea and he went to Barcelona. And I'm gonna leave the link in the description so you can just click and watch the video that I made back then, and also a compilation video that I made so you can judge him by yourself. He got skills, man. The guy is a tank. 6.5 already, 18 years old. So he could get like 6'6 or something like that. Very good player, but let's not hype him that much, okay? Because many people are comparing him to Van Dijk and calling him all kind of, you know, good names. It's okay to hype a young players, but hey, let him be his own player. He's not Van Dijk. He will never be a Van Dijk or John Terry or anybody, okay? Let him play his football. Don't put too much pressure on the kid, okay? Don't expect too much. He needs to develop slowly and surely, just like any youngster. And don't compare him to, I don't know, Delit or other youngsters that came to the top level earlier, because every player is different. Frank Lampard promised to promote him to the first team in about 2 seasons. So, according to what I'm hearing, he's going on loan, maybe to the championship, so he can play the main games, get experience and come back. And I wanna compare him a little bit with Levy. Levy is another youngster in the academy who is killing it, the same age as Xavier Buyamba. This guy is a left-footed centre-back. So I am just speculating here that in the next coming years, we could see Levy and Xavier as our centre-back pairing. Who knows? Stay tuned, because I am preparing a video about Levy. I've already made a video about Bate and other youngsters from the academy. I know many people don't want to watch those kind of videos because they don't care about the youth. They just care about the finished articles. I will encourage you to start watching the development of young players. You're gonna thank me later, because you're gonna be more patient and you're gonna understand football better. When you see a kid developing to become a big star, it makes you appreciate the process. And that's why I am very patient with the youngsters, because I know it's a process and they are going to have up and downs, and eventually will make it at some point in their lives if they continue working very hard. The future is bright at Chelsea, man. Say whatever you want, but in couple seasons from now, Chelsea are going to be in the next level, because we're not gonna need to buy big stars. We are going to produce our own stars from the club. Anyways, I wish Frank Lampard could take Xavier Buyamba to preseason. You know what I mean? Like, just look at him a little bit closer, okay? Give him the preseason before sending him on loan. Just see how he's going to train. Maybe you might change your mind. That's what Ranieri did with John Terry, okay? He was in the academy and Ranieri went to watch the game and he was like, no, your place is not here anymore. You are coming with me in the first team. And the rest is history. Anyways, guys, let me know what you think about Xavier Buyamba. Are you excited? Okay, let's now talk about Mr. Isaiah Brown, or Izzy Brown, whatever you want to call him. Man, this guy is tired of getting loaned. I don't want to see him going on loan anymore, but unfortunately he's going on loan at Sheffield Wednesday. Not the United one, because United are in the Premier League, but Wednesday are in the Championship. Correct me if I'm wrong, but Izzy Brown going back to the Championship on loan. I think he's been all over the world. At some point he went to Vitesse. Correct me if I'm wrong. Just leave your comment in the description down below. Because I remember watching him at Vitesse. I might be wrong, but I think so. Izzy is already 23 years old. Yeah, older than Tammy Abraham. He's kind of the same generation with Tammy Abraham, Dominic Solanke, and you can even say Andreas Christensen. Christensen is only 24. They played together with Izzy Brown and some other youngsters. They won pretty much everything. The Champions League in the youth level, the FA Cup, the Premier League, everything. He's part of the golden generation that never had a chance from the ex-managers. So for me, it's time for Chelsea to sell Izzy Brown. Find him a permanent home so he can develop. I know people in his generation are already killing it at some level now, but he's been shipped all over the world, playing in different positions and kind of killed his confidence. We have to sell him and put a buyback clause, so if he explodes in the future, we can buy him back. But right now, I don't see him breaking to the first team. Man been on loan at more than six clubs that I can remember at the top of my head. Brighton, Leeds, Bristol City, Championship, League One, Luton Town, Vitesse, everywhere. How do you expect a player to be stable and develop? The same thing happened to Lewis Becker, who is 26 now and can't find a club. We killed him. Oh man, Lewis Becker, I'm still hurting. He was one of the best youngsters coming from the academy. He won the Academy Player of the Year, maybe a couple times. And Mourinho said, if Becker doesn't make it to the national team in few seasons from now, blame me. But guess what? The next morning, he was sent on loan. Mourinho can tell you everything you wanna hear, but he won't respect one damn thing. So guys, let me know what you think about Izzy Brown. Okay, let's now have some fun with some weird kind of kit, really, in the Premier League and also in the Championship. This one is from Bristol City. Oh my gosh. This kit is for the goalkeepers. And for me, it looks a little bit busy. It's just like a clown show or something like that. Man, let me know if you can wear something like this. Because me, no. I like to keep my low profile. No too much color. And this is just too busy, too much for me. It looks like the goalkeepers in the 90s or something like that, man. It might be their history or something, but for me, no, really. Let's now check on Arsenal crime scene kit. They look like zombies. Man, I'm not gonna be able to wear something like this. I don't know about you, but for me, nope. It's so confusing. It looks like blood everywhere, and it looks like nobody is enjoying wearing it. Even the players that modeled for the kit, you can see here, Ozil, sad even to wear it, but he has no choice. And all kind of memes going on online right now, man. Look at that, man. It looks like a jersey from hell. What happened to Adidas? They used to produce the best kit in the world. What happened to them? They are following Nike? You know, I've been complaining about Chelsea third kit from Nike and complaining about how awful and how much I miss Adidas. But now I kind of feel good, you know, knowing that I don't have to deal with this. You know what I mean? Anyways, guys, that was just for banter, for fun, because football is also about having fun. Don't take everything seriously. Leave your comment. Be cool like N'Golo Kante. Think outside the box, and see you in the next one.